Hello everyone, this is Pragya Satpathy. In today's video, I am going to explain how to create folders, nested folder under a folder, and copy files in a specific folder in the SharePoint document library when an item is created in the SharePoint list on the Power Apps button click. So let's jump into my screen to see how it works. This is my Power Apps screen. I'll give an employee name as Trinica and I'll save this. Let's see in the SharePoint site, the documents folder. The employee name folder is created. And in my admin folder, few documents are here. And I want all the files to copy it in the nested folder. I have two nested folders. And all the files are copied here along with the document ID, which is a lookup ID from the SharePoint list in which the item is created. I hope this concept will be interesting to implement this on your application. So let's get started. Before that, my introduction. So this is my SharePoint site. I'll create a list here. Choose blank list. I'll give the list name as employee information. And I'll create a list. I'll just change the title column as employee name. So let's go to the title column to edit the column name. So I'll just add here employee name and click on OK. I'll get my column name changed. So let's see in the Power Apps screen how to create an item here in Power Apps, and it will be added in the SharePoint list, and the same column name folder will be added here in the documents folder. So let's SharePoint, then list name and connect. So first I'll add a label, just add a text input. I'll add as employee name. So let's add a button on the screen and I'll just change the text property of the button to save. And write on the onSelect property of the button to save the data in the SharePoint list. So for that, I will use the patch function. Patch the SharePoint list name. As we are creating a new record, so defaults, again the SharePoint list name. This is the basic syntax of saving a new record to the SharePoint list. Column name, SharePoint column name here as employee name, and the parameter I will pass as the text input, the emp name dot text. Create a folder in the documents library. We have to write a flow on the Power Automate. So let's create a new flow. I'll choose the automated cloud flow. I'll give a flow name as employee name folder, and I'll choose an action as when an item is created, create. So the flow is created. I'll give a site address as the same site address I have in the SharePoint list. So the folders in SP library, and the list name is employee information. I'll add a new step. I'll search for create new folder. And the site address will be the same site address in which I want to create a folder. The list or library name will be documents. And the folder path will be employee name. As under the documents folder, I am creating a folder as per this employee name. So let's save this. Now, to create an item, so let's give an employee name and I'll save this. The item is created in the employee information list. So let's the name as Pragya Satpathy folder is created here few seconds ago. In this library, I will add a new column for the ID, which will be lookup from the employee list. So let's go to library settings. Create a column. Suppose document ID. Get information from employee information. And in this column, the information will be ID. So let's click OK. So it will be a SharePoint lookup column. So let's see how we can associate the SharePoint ID here in this document library. So for this, let's go to the flow, new step, and search for update file properties. And in this, the site address will be the same site address we have used for the folder. Then the library name is documents. And here the ID will be the folder ID, the create new folder ID, and the document ID ID is the column which we created here, document ID. It's showing here, and in this ID, the when an item is created, that ID. So let's save this and we'll test the same flow. The document ID is 1 as the employee information list ID is 1. How we can create multiple folders under this folder? For this, on the new step, initialize variable. And suppose the variable name will be var folders. And it will be an array, as I am going to create multiple folders under this. Like one will be personal documents and another will be official documents for an employee. And the new step will be apply to H. The same variable will, and here I will search for create new folder, and the site address will be the same site address, documents, and the folder path will be employee name, as we are going to create the folders under the employee name. Then class and the current item. So now let's see, let's add a employee name as employee 1. And now let's check in the document library. You can check the employee 1 folder is created few seconds ago. The employee 1 folder, the personal documents, official documents, both the folders are created. With the similar action, update file properties, I'll update the document ID of these two folders by adding the action here, update file properties. Second, let's see, I have some documents in the admin folder. I want all these documents to be copied on the official document folder of every employee. So let's see how it works. In this case, for this, I will add get file properties. In this, the site address can be any site from your site collection, and the library name is documents, and I will add the path of the folder in which the documents are. And in this action, it will extract all the documents from the folder. And this value is for each document. And the copy file action will copy all the documents from the existing folder. And I will give here the current site address in which I want to copy all the documents. File to copy, the identifier is required. And the destination site address, the same site address we have used. And the destination folder will be shared documents, employee name folder, and the official documents. And it is mandatory that if another file is already there, then we have to replace the file. And similarly, I will update the document ID by adding the same employee information ID so that the file will be distinguished for which employee it is created. Stay tuned with me for more tips and tricks on Power Apps. Thank you for watching.